GOP Representative Jim Renacci announces Ohio Senate bid. Republican Rep. Jim RenacciJames, Jim, B. RenacciOvernight Health Care, 5 Takeaways from Trump Health Picks Hearing. Dodge takes new steps to fight opioid epidemic. ObamaCare enrollment slows. GOP bill would limit opioid prescriptions for first-time users report. Ohio Rep. gives illegal donation to his own gubernatorial campaign. More. Ohio announced Thursday that he's running for Ohio's Senate seat in 2018 after being encouraged by the White House to mount a Senate bid. Renacci, who's been running in the Ohio governor's race since last March, ended his gubernatorial bid and will instead run to be the Republican candidate in the Ohio Senate race. His decision to jump into the Senate race comes days after Ohio State Treasurer Josh Mandel, who was considered the front-runner, surprisingly ended his bid, citing his wife's health issues. Renacci reportedly met with President Trump. Donald John Trump. House Democrat slams Donald Trump Jr. for serious case of amnesia after testimony. Skier Lindsey Vonn, I don't want to represent Trump at Olympics poll. 4 in 10 Republicans think senior Trump advisors had improper dealings with Russia. Moore's political team this week, during which he was urged to run to unseat Sen. Sherrod Brown. Sherrod Campbell Brown. The Hill's 1230 report. Avalanche of Democratic senators say Franken should resign. Overnight regulation, Fed's push to clarify regs on bump stocks. Interior wants Trump to shrink to more monuments. Navajo Nation sues over monument rollback. FCC won't delay net neutrality vote. Senate panel approves bill easing Dodd-Frank rules. More. D. Ohio. The Ohio congressman confirmed the decision during a Thursday morning appearance on AM 120 The Answer in Cleveland. I now realize after meeting with the White House yesterday I really need to put country first and answer the call to action to serve our nation and come back to try and fight for the Trump agenda and try to get things done in the Senate, he said. When the president and the administration calls you to action, it was a pretty compelling moment for me. So this morning I announced that, after speaking to my family and my advisors and my supporters, I've announced that I am going to switch and answer the call of the president, help the president in his quest to try to change Washington, and I'm going to run against Sherrod Brown. The Ohio representative has served in Congress since 2011 and has been a staunch supporter of Trump's agenda over the last year. He is expected to play up his close relationship with the White House during the campaign. When the congressman announced his gubernatorial campaign, he launched a campaign website, OhioFirst.com, a nod to Trump's America First slogan. Renacci's bid shakes up the top-tier race as other serious contenders weigh launching their own campaigns. Renacci joins wealthy businessman Mike Gibbons, who has been running for Senate since last May, in the GOP primary. Gibbons has been touting and rolling out more local endorsements and pledged to pump another $5 million into his campaign. The GOP field could get another curveball as another high-profile. GOP Representative Jim Renacci announces Ohio Senate bid. Republican Rep. Jim RenacciJames, Jim, B. Renacci Overnight Health Care, 5 Takeaways from Trump Health Picks Hearing. Dodge takes new steps to fight opioid epidemic. ObamaCare enrollment slows. GOP bill would limit opioid prescriptions for first-time users report. Ohio Rep. gives illegal donation to his own gubernatorial campaign. More. Ohio announced Thursday that he's running for Ohio's Senate seat in 2018 after being encouraged by the White House to mount a Senate bid. Renacci, who's been running in the Ohio governor's race since last March, ended his gubernatorial bid and will instead run to be the Republican candidate in the Ohio Senate race. His decision to jump into the Senate race comes days after Ohio State Treasurer Josh Mandel, who was considered the front-runner, surprisingly ended his bid, citing his wife's health issues. Renacci reportedly met with President Trump. Donald John Trump. House Democrat slams Donald Trump Jr. for serious case of amnesia after testimony. Skier Lindsey Vonn, I don't want to represent Trump at Olympics poll. 4 in 10 Republicans think senior Trump advisors had improper dealings with Russia. Moore's political team this week, during which he was urged to run to unseat Sen. Sherrod Brown. Sherrod Campbell Brown. The Hill's 1230 report. Avalanche of Democratic senators say Franken should resign overnight regulation. Feds push to clarify regs on bump stocks. Interior wants Trump to shrink two more monuments. Navajo Nation sues over monument rollback. FCC won't delay net neutrality vote. Senate panel approves bill easing Dodd-Frank rules more. D. Ohio. The Ohio congressman confirmed the decision during a Thursday morning appearance on AM 120 The Answer in Cleveland. I now realize after meeting with the White House yesterday I really need to put country first and answer the call to action to serve our nation and come back to try and fight for the Trump agenda and try to get things done in the Senate, he said. When the president and the administration calls you to action, it was a pretty compelling moment for me. So this morning I announced that, after speaking to my family and my advisors and my supporters, I've announced that I am going to switch and answer the call of the president, help the president in his quest to try to change Washington, and I'm going to run against Sherrod Brown. The Ohio representative has served in Congress since 2011 and has been a staunch supporter of Trump's agenda over the last year. He is expected to play up his close relationship with the White House during the campaign. When the congressman announced his gubernatorial campaign, he launched a campaign website, OhioFirst.com, a nod to Trump's America First slogan. Renacci's bid shakes up the top-tier race as other serious contenders weigh launching their own campaigns. Renacci joins wealthy businessman Mike Gibbons, who has been running for Senate since last May, in the GOP primary. Gibbons has been touting and rolling out more local endorsements and pledged to pump another $5 million into his campaign. The GOP field could get another curveball as another high-profile contender mulls the race. J.D. Vance, author of Hillbilly Elegy, is reportedly seriously considering a bid. He initially ruled out a campaign last year, but has been reconsidering since Mandel's exit. Donors have been encouraging him to run, and Vance met with Republicans in Washington this week to discuss a potential bid. He also met with Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell. Addison, Mitch, Mitchell McConnell. Strategist donates to Alabama Democrat. McConnell names Senate GOP tax confreeze Brent Doski, a plea to Alabama voters more, Arky, on Monday. The primary is on May 8, and the filing deadline to run is February 7. Whoever emerges from the Republican primary will have a tough battle against Brown, who has been in the Senate since 2007 and has been a staple in Ohio politics. He won his re-election in 2012 against Mandel by 6 points. But Trump carried Ohio in the 2016 election by more than 8 points, and the race is expected to draw national attention and millions of dollars as Democrats seek to protect incumbents in red states. Contender mulls the race. J.D. Vance, author of Hillbilly Elegy, is reportedly seriously considering a bid. He initially ruled out a campaign last year, but has been reconsidering since Mandel's exit. Donors have been encouraging him to run, and Vance met with Republicans in Washington this week to discuss a potential bid. He also met with Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell. Addison, Mitch, Mitchell McConnell. Strategist donates to Alabama Democrat. McConnell names Senate GOP tax confreeze Brent Doski, a plea to Alabama voters more, Arky, on Monday. The primary is on May 8, and the filing deadline to run is February 7. Whoever emerges from the Republican primary will have a tough battle against Brown, who has been in the Senate since 2007 and has been a staple in Ohio politics. He won his re-election in 2012 against Mandel by 6 points. But Trump carried Ohio in the 2016 election by more than 8 points, and the race is expected to draw national attention and millions of dollars as Democrats seek to protect incumbents in red states.